Inside the ornate homes of Tampa's high society, high-ranking military officers stationed here often enjoy red carpet star treatment with open doors to a circuit of fancy charity and social parties.
For people from MacDill to attend social functions that people in the community have on their behalf. I mean, that's just one way that people in the community show their appreciation for MacDill.
While General Petraeus and his mistress biographer, Paula Broadwell, have disappeared from public view, it's Jill Kelly's role in the scandal that's getting the most attention, to the dismay of many friends and acquaintances. Former Tampa Mayor Pam Iorio says she's attended several parties the Kellys have organized.
The fact that this one couple held parties for people from MacDill would really not have registered very much, I think, on anyone's screen anywhere. That just wouldn't have been that important to anyone here that one couple would host parties for MacDill personnel.
Aaron Fodeman has published Tampa Bay Magazine for 27 years. He's enjoyed a front row seat to wine and dine with Tampa's elite and published these photos of Jill Kelly since he first met her 12 years ago. Fodeman says military generals became popular party guests after the first Gulf War in the early 1990s with the larger-than-life made-for-TV general, Storman Norman Schwarzkopf.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for being here.
He was what I think of as the first really high-profile, very personable general that everybody knew the name and everybody realized he was stationed here.
Over the years, Jill Kelly made quite an impression on officials at MacDill Air Force Base, which is home to the U.S. military's Central Command. After a background check, she was deemed, quote, a friend of MacDill, which gave her special access to the military base without an escort. That access has now been suspended. And because of her role as a booster and promoter of military programs for the troops, the U.S. Central Command also bestowed upon her the title of honorary ambassador, albeit an unofficial position with no power. But Jill Kelly's friends say to suggest that this board-rich socialite, as she's been described, who came out of nowhere to befriend high-ranking generals and their families, is simply wrong.
She's been in the community for 12 years. It's over a length of time. It's not like she just got here a year ago. I mean, she's been in the community. They've been here. I don't know how long it took for her to become friends with. But everybody likes the military people. They're lovely people. They're nice. Nobody can object to wanting to be friends with these people. They're lovely.
And someone like Jill Kelly has been there to host the fancy soiree. Ed Lavandera, CNN, Tampa, Florida.